Hi, this is Tony Ridnell for Rugby Wrap-Up in Seattle.
Coming up next on Rugby Wrap-Up, Matt McCarthy and Steve Lewis talking Major League Rugby.
Rugby Wrap-Up brought to you in part by Irish Rugby Tours, the Rugby Tours people. A balanced palate, nutrition for peak performance. AFIA Sports Training Group and Big and Whistle on West 36th Street, the world's best rugby pub.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Rugby Wrap-Up. Matt McCarthy and Steve Lewis at the Fantasy Sports Network Studio 34 in New York City. And Steve, we have different segments that we were able to get in Seattle because everybody was really gracious. They were really accommodating. And then Tony Ridnell was kind enough to take the role of correspondent for Rugby Wrap-Up and did one heck of a job interviewing Phil Mack and Shalom Suniula in their apartment building. Check this out.
Shalom, what was it like playing in front of that crowd? Obviously, Seattle has is gaining a reputation as one of the nastiest places to play, and maybe the only nasty place to play. What'd you think about that?
The atmosphere was great. The boys thrive under that sort of atmosphere, and they really get behind us. And so, I mean, the Seattle crowd as a whole, the boys love it. We enjoy playing in front of them. Like, I could barely hear two players in, if that nice. Makes sense. So it was pretty incredible.
Nice. Well, it was pretty incredible being in the stands itself. Quick change of subject. The U.S. Eagles are playing in Seattle on March 8th against Canada. And sitting to my left is Phil Mack, who's going to be captain in Canada probably against the Eagles at Starfire Sports. What's that going to be like, Phil, playing at Starfire, where you've become a hero for the team for sure? What's that going to be like?
I'm excited. I think it speaks to, what's being built at Starfire and the draw and the want and need for more rugby there. So from my perspective, it's going to feel like home, but I'm just excited to share that experience with the Canadians.
And then we've got a new Canadian team in the league, obviously, Toronto Arrows. What's that going to be like playing against your home country boys?
Familiar is one thing. Okay. I think, I got a lot of friends on that team, and I'm expecting a good game. I think they're going to get a lot better. It's tough to go down south and play, but, from my personal standpoint, I just want to have a bit of bragging rights, so I'm really looking forward to that game.
Talk a little bit, Shalom, if you would, about that type of travel and obviously geography in the United States.
Yeah, travel will play a huge factor. Like playing in New Orleans, I found they're one of the toughest travels, and let alone we haven't even gone to the East Coast yet. Right. That'll take its toll, especially as the season goes on.
So one of the issues is that if you play away for the first five or six games of the season, you come home, you could be 0-5. You're not going to have any fan base. You could be 5-0, and maybe someone comes out. It comes like that. Phil, what are your thoughts on, play, would you rather play four away games and kind of be more amenable to the good weather, or would you rather kind of fight it out in the muck up there in the cold just to be able to have your home field advantage?
It's a good question. I'm sure, obviously you don't want to start five away games in a row, but at the end of the day it comes down to a safety issue, and is the field even playable? And we're playing at a pretty high level now. The intensity is going through the roof. So if you add in frozen ground, it's just one thing that as a player you don't want to deal with. And the duration of the season, you want to have healthy bodies. Obviously it's not ideal for these teams that have to travel, but the league has just made a way to fix it, and they're going to have a tough start to the season. But at the tail end of it, they're going to have a bit of an edge.
We got a sign from the executive producer. We got to cut it off. So final question. Management has asked for the spectators to be quiet during kicks. What are your thoughts on that, Shalom?
I think each international country has a different approach. I don't know. We're still trying to find our identity when it comes to that. But I think it should be an interesting approach to the rest of the season. I'll be interested to see.
No, I agree. I think the fans kind of have to set their own culture and what they want to put out there. And on the flip side, some countries, they are very quiet. And then you go to other countries and it's, mayhem. You go to Argentina. I watched Argentina versus the All Blacks and it was like nothing I've ever seen. It was pretty crazy. Yeah, yeah. Everyone has their opinion, but ultimately, in Seattle we want to do, we want the fans to do, what they feel comfortable.
This is Tony Ridnell for Phil and Shalom. We'll wrap it up with Rugby Wrap-Up in Seattle.
Very jealous. Very jealous. I've been there before. Yeah. I know that facility really well, but that's a special atmosphere. It looks like they got going.
Yeah. But on that note, Stephen, we're out of time.
Thank you.
Thank you. Matt McCarthy and Steve Lewis from the Fantasy Sports Network Studio 34 in New York City signing off.